Hello and welcome to this session on web services. Today we are going to learn what a web service is, what is the basic concept behind web services, and why do we use it. So let us begin and let us see what a web service is. So we can say web service is a service available over the web. Now this is a very straightforward expansion of the word web service. But what does it actually mean? So let us see. Let us say that we go to a hotel or a restaurant. So let us say this is you and you have gone to a hotel for having your dinner. Okay, so this is you and let us say this is the kitchen from where the food will be served. So this is the kitchen. Okay, now what we are going to have is we are going to communicate our order to the kitchen and the kitchen is going to serve our order. Okay, now there is a person who is involved in this communication process. The person takes your order from your table, goes to the kitchen, places the order, and then takes your food from the kitchen once it is prepared, and you get your food through the same person. And who is that person? So that person is a waiter, right? So let us say this is our waiter who is doing all this communication between you and the kitchen. So this is our waiter. Okay, so his responsibility is he has to take your order, go to the kitchen, then make sure the kitchen prepares the order and serve you back. Now here our waiter is performing the role of a web service API, or we can also say web service. He is communicating between two applications and making sure that the communication is proper and successful. Okay. Now, you might have a question that what is the criticality of the presence of this particular person in this communication process? Even if this person or waiter is not present, you can still go and place your order to the kitchen and then take it from there and have your food. Okay. Now think about a scenario. You speak English and the chef who is present inside the kitchen speaks German and you do not understand each other. In that case, here is a person who makes sure that you two applications can communicate with each other, and whatever response you have to get from the server or whatever request a server has to get from a client is in a format where two entities can understand each other and communicate. So here you are a client and kitchen is a server and you are communicating with each other. So therefore the presence of this waiter or web services becomes very important. Let us see a practical example. Let me go to a website like makemytrip.com and let us try to book a flight. So I'm booking a flight from, let's say, India, New Delhi to Mumbai. Okay, and let me just click search flights. So see what this website is doing. It is searching for all the flights between New Delhi to Mumbai on some particular date, and within few seconds it has given me all the options. So all the airlines, Air India, Jet Airways, Go Air, Vistara and all other airlines, all the information about their flights have been listed out within few seconds. So what has actually happened here? Let us try to understand this, what has happened here. So let us say this is the website Make My Trip. Okay, and this is Air India, this is Go Air, this is Indigo, then we have Jet Airways, and others like Vistara and so on. So what Make My Trip website has done in our example, it has communicated between these websites, right? So whether it is GoAir, whether it is Indigo, it has sent some request, received back a response, and then displayed the details of all the flights of all these websites. Okay, so this is what has just happened in our practical example. Now, what do you think? How is it possible for a website like Make My Trip to query the databases of all these websites, all these applications, real time, and provide us information of all the flights within a few seconds? Well, one of the ways is this particular website, Make My Trip, or this particular application has access to the databases of all these websites, of all these airlines. But that might not be the case here, because no airline's website or airlines will allow a third party to go inside their database for some obvious reasons, and for some security reasons it will not allow. So that might not be the case. Okay, there can be a second possibility that these airlines are dumping all the data or all the information about their flights to Make My Trip every hour or every half an hour. Okay, that can be practically possible, but think about the situation. The status of the flights can get changed every second. Okay, in that case we need real-time data. What if somebody tries to book a flight, but that flight got cancelled 5 minutes ago, but Make My Trip will show that that is available, and then there will be a lot of chaos, right? So that cannot be the case either. Now what happens here is all these airlines have exposed their web services through an API, and this website makemytrip.com uses those web services to communicate between the airlines. Okay, so it has a common format in which it sends out a request and receives back the response in the same format, and that response is shown on their website here. Okay, so this is how they are communicating, and this is how they are making use of web services. Okay, so now you can appreciate the use of web services. Let me also put this down here. So web services is a service available over the web. It enables communication between application over the web, and it provides a standard protocol or format for communication. And this standard and standard protocol and format, we will look into details in our coming sessions. Okay, and we have already seen the basic concept behind the web services. We will go more details into the architecture, but we know what exactly a web service has to do, right? Okay, so why we use it? Because it provides a platform independent communication. So you can have an application written in C++ over a Windows platform, and then there can be another application written in Java over a Linux platform. These two applications can talk to each other using web services. Okay, so that is why using web services we can enable communication between two different applications, and that is why we use web services. So in the coming sessions we will go into more details about web services, and we will also look at what are the different types of web services. Thanks for watching.